Booting from a hard drive can take you about 3 minutes. Booting from an M.2 SSD takes you about 30 seconds, maybe even less. In this video, I'm going to show you the features of Partition Master. I'm going to clone from this hard drive to an M.2 drive. Then afterwards, I'm going to go ahead and partition the drive because we're going to get 500 gig on both, and then I'm going to expand it to 2 terabytes. So come with me as I show you how to master your disk drive. Let's go. 145 seconds and 937 milliseconds. To boot into Windows 11, let's go into Google Chrome. Bear with me, it takes a while. Even though it's a fast PC, we're bottled down by the mechanical drive. So we're going to go ahead and use Partition Master. We're going to use the free version, but we can always go ahead and update to the paid version. One sec while I put in my information here. Okay, so then here it tells me the differences between the free version and professional. There are quite a few differences. We also see the price. Oh, look at that. We saved some money here. And I'm going to save you a little bit more. Stay tuned for that one. Pay close attention to what I say in this video. There's a giveaway and you can miss it easily. So we'll do the free version for now. And I'll go ahead and close this and we'll install it. We can choose defaults. All right, once it's installed, it's going to pop up with this. Again, reminding you of the free, the 1 year, and the lifetime upgrade. I'd personally go with the lifetime upgrade and lifetime upgrades to the latest version. That's a pretty good deal there. So I'll go ahead and just close this out for now and start now. And once the program's open under discovery, we get to see a bunch of the different programs and features and everything that they provide. Pretty awesome. And under Partition Manager, I just realized we don't even have the drive in there yet. Let's go ahead and install that real quick. So I'm going to go ahead and shut down for now. Now I'm just going to quickly install it here. If you don't know how to install it, you can go ahead and check out the video up above where I show you how to install it as a secondary drive. Easy enough, installed. Let's go ahead, plug it back in and get back into Windows. All right, so we'll just go back into the BIOS. We'll go under advanced mode and we'll come under boot. I just want to make sure that we are still booting under the Hitachi and nothing else has gotten in his way. So perfect. We'll go ahead, save and exit. All right, so now after waiting 3 minutes and 8 seconds to get back into Windows, let's go ahead and open up Partition Master again. And it's going to open up to my disks. What we saw before, the Hitachi drive, and then now drive zero, the NVMe Sovereign Rocket 4 Plus Gaming, close to 8,000 megabytes per second. Coming back over here, we also have disk clone, which is what we're going to end up doing. We have the options to migrate an operating system, clone an OS disk, clone the data, or clone a single partition. Then we also have a disk converter. We have the ability to convert MBR to GPT. Now that's incredibly important, especially if you're going from a 500 gig drive like I am to a 2 terabyte or larger drive. You need to have GPT instead of MBR. A quick, easy way to find out if you have MBR or GPT is to right click on the start button, then click device manager, then open up your disk drives, and then right click on the drive you're using now for your operating system, and then properties, then select volumes and click populate. So right now you can see I'm using GPT. If you're doing a fresh install of Windows on Windows 11, you can only select GPT. You can't do MBR anymore. But if you came from Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows 7, or you're cloning those, you might be under MBR. It's always best to be GPT. So after that, we have the ability to convert from GPT over to MBR. You don't want to do that. Convert a dynamic disk to basic disk, or convert a basic disk to dynamic disk. Then partition recovery. If, let's say, when you're expanding a drive, which Partition Master lets you do, if something happens to that partition, maybe over time, this will allow you to potentially recover that partition and recover the data from it. So that's great. Bootable media, incredibly valuable in case you have disk corruption or anything along those lines. This allows you to create a bootable media that allows you to boot into the WinPE environment, or the Windows pre-installation environment, that allows you to run many different commands. Then below that, enable Partition Master pre-OS, which allows you to add a WinPE selection in the boot menu, or burn an ISO, allows you to download or burn the Windows ISO to a USB drive or a CD disk. And then Toolkit is nice. This allows you to download the ISO for 7, 8, 10, or Windows 11. Allows you to reset your password. So if you forget the password to your Windows install, you can come in here, make a bootable USB drive, and then boot to that and reset that password. This allows you to create a boot repair solution. As it says, a one-click solution to fix various Windows startup problems. Write protection allows you to write protect certain drives. This is to rebuild your MBR as opposed to GPT. Your MBR is your master boot record on older disks, allows you to repair that. 4K alignment basically allows your drive to process data more efficiently. Clicking on that, for example, and then selecting your sovereign because the other one isn't an SSD. And then we click start. That one's already been aligned, so that's great. Now what we want to do is we want to go over here to disk clone. Under disk clone, we have the option to either migrate OS or clone OS disk. Cloning is a bit by bit copy of one drive to another. It would be an exact copy of one drive and another drive. And then migrate OS is almost the same, but it doesn't really care about the exact bits. I recommend to clone your disk. I'm a little bit scared of that one. Not that it's bad, but I prefer a bit by bit. So it's going to take a little bit longer. Remember, this involves a hard drive, a 133 meg per second drive to an M.2 SSD, an up to 8,000 meg per second drive. So it's going to be cloning from one drive to the other. So it's going to go incredibly slow, 133 megabytes per second. That's going to be very slow. Whereas going from an SSD to an M.2 SSD is 650 megabytes up to 8,000. Going from an M.2 to an M.2 is anywhere from, let's say, 1,000 megabytes per second to 8,000. So it's definitely going to be a lot quicker the faster both pieces of media are. And then here we click next, clone OS disk. This is the main disk. Now here it's saying select a destination disk. So it already knows that this is the source. This is the main drive we're copying from. Selecting here, in case there were many, allows us to select the destination disk. And then we click next. Do you want to continue cloning? Clone will permanently wipe out all data on target disk. To repeat that, when you're cloning, you're taking all of the contents from one drive and putting that on another drive. That doesn't mean you're adding more data to this destination drive. This means you're totally clearing out that destination drive and making an exact copy. That's going to make a little more sense in 1 second. Okay, once we understand that we're going to lose everything on the destination drive, we'll click yes. Now this gives us the option to autofit or clone as the source. You probably want to do autofit, but just to show you a few of the tools inside of Partition Master, I'm going to select clone as source. Now what that did, it shrunk the destination drive, a 2 terabyte drive, down to the size of this 500 gigabyte drive. So that gives us 1.36 terabytes of unallocated space. With that, if we wanted to, we can create a separate partition, let's say a D drive or an E drive, so that we can install games on, files, all that stuff, all without messing with the source drive. It's on the same disk. It's kind of just splitting the disk into separate pieces of that disk. But again, all contained in that one disk. And then we can select sector by sector clone, but that's going to be a lot slower. Since this is a premium feature of Partition Master Disk, I'm gonna go ahead and register this. Using the cloning feature, we're actually using a little bit more than what a Partition Master is. We're not editing partitions, we're actually cloning. So this is a premium feature. If we wanted to play with the partitions, that would be included in Partition Master. So I'm gonna go ahead and register this real quick. For the first 100 viewers, I have a key for you for the full version. Check it out down below, all the way at the very bottom. Tell your friends to check out the video as well. They'll be happy they did. So here with clone as the source, I'll click activate. I'll enter my license. 1 second. All right. So after I've activated, I'll go ahead and click on the X here. And now I'll click start. Now this is going to take a while. It says 8 minutes, but you see how that's climbing up. So we'll be right back. Another thing that's going to determine how long this clone will take is how much data you have on your drive. This is a clean install of Windows with some updates and drivers, so I don't have a whole lot. If you've used this drive for a number of years, you've built up a lot of data on there, so that might take some time. So it could take anywhere from a few minutes to a few hours. Now that we're done cloning, we need to tell the BIOS which drive we want it to boot from. Let's do that real quick. So then here we'll select reboot now. Now that we're back in the BIOS, realize that your BIOS may look different than mine. I'm going to go into advanced mode and then we're going to go into boot. Here's where we get to select the drives. So here we can see the Sovereign Rocket and then the Windows Boot Manager, which is the Hitachi. Boot option number one. And then we need to make sure that we're under the Sovereign Rocket, which is a little bit odd considering it doesn't have a boot manager. The Sovereign Rocket is the main boot drive. We'll go ahead and hit F10, save and exit. Though we didn't make any changes, this was a just in case. And then we'll click OK. So it seems that like the initial restart, if it is on the SSD, takes a little bit longer because it's trying to reconfigure the operating system to know that, hey, I'm on an SSD now, I'm not on a mechanical drive. All right, so coming into here, and now things are much faster. Now, OneDrive is going a little crazy because things have been moved around a little bit. So if you do use OneDrive, you're going to have to reconfigure some things. So here we can't tell the difference other than they're two of the exact same drives. So what we're going to do is let's go into Partition Master. And then opening up Partition Manager, Disk Zero, the NVMe Sovereign Rocket 4 Plus Gaming, we can see everything this one has, including that free space, but it looks a little bit smaller here. But we can also see unallocated, that 1.36. So what we could do here is utilize the partition portion of this program. We'll right click under unallocated, we'll select create, and then we can change that. If we want to make it many different partitions, we can do that, but I'll leave it as one partition and I'll maybe drive letter, I could change that to maybe F, and I'm going to name this F drive, even though it already say F, but anyway, and I'll leave it under NTFS and I'll click OK. And it hasn't made the change yet. It's letting me execute it. So I can do a few other things before I do that, but let's go ahead and execute it real quick. Execute one task and we'll click apply. That took a few seconds and we'll click done here. Excellent, running great so far. And then if we open up File Explorer and this PC, we can see 500 gigs here and then 1.36 terabytes named F drive. That is the F drive. We can come under here, regular File Explorer, and we'll do properties and we'll name this new C drive. Continue here and okay. And this is our D drive, the old drive. We can tell by the D drive. All right, so we've completely cloned a drive under clone OS disk, and then we've partitioned the drive with the partition manager. There's so much more on this program. And again, disk converter, I would have loved to have shown you MBR to GPT, but the drive was already GPT. Then we can go under toolkit. Now that we have a new one, we'll select 4K alignment. We'll select that Sovereign drive. Here gives us the option for both, but I'll select Sovereign and I'll click start, but it's already been aligned, so we're good there. And now let's check real quick boot ratio to see how quickly it boots up now. We'll do a new test. So 1 second, be right back. All the way down to 43 seconds. Now, I can do a lot more to speed that up, but going from what, a minute and a half, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, whatever that time was before, down to 43 seconds, That's a tremendous improvement. Now, instead of programs taking so long, if you just right click them to get to the properties or to even start them, now they're almost instant. That is a tremendous weight off of your shoulders, because now you feel so much more free inside of the operating system now, and you didn't even have to reinstall Windows, though I still recommend it. But Partition Master gives you so many great options. Again, cloning, partitioning, changing from MBR to GPT, GPT to MBR, and so many other things. I definitely think you should check it out. Again, I have 100 keys down in the description below for those first few 100. After that, I can't help you. I'll see if I can get a discount code for you, but check down below just in case anyway. This is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou, showing you all of the awesome features of Partition Master. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.